perhaps a lot of rain showers moving from west to east across our region. We're starting to see the back end of the rain showers as it continues to move from the west to the east. So they'll only be lasting for just a few more hours, but if you are traveling around the Beltway, you will have the rain showers, as I said, till about noon or so. So the headlines for us today, and we're looking forward to the rain ending. So for the afternoon, if you're traveling to any type of parties or engagements, the road should be dry. And then for tomorrow night, we'll do it all over again with heavy rain that starts moving Monday night. Could end in a wintry mix for your Tuesday as the temperatures get a bit colder. So Adam, we're not done with February yet.
Yeah, we'll be keeping an eye on that. All right, Clay, thank you very much. A reminder, you can get the latest news and weather anytime with the NBC Washington app. Have a great Sunday, everybody.
Oh, hello, you. I'm filming television. Won't you join me for a little stroll? Oh. Like the paradise I like to call the town where I currently am.
Catherine O'Hara with the wardrobe, the wings, and that accent as the proudly eccentric Moira Rhodes on the hit series Schitt's Creek. That unforgettable role earned O'Hara an Emmy, a Golden Globe, and a SAG Award, solidifying her status as an icon of comedy. The ride that has made O'Hara such a fan favorite began at the Second City in Toronto, where she started out as a waitress before stepping on stage to perform in a roster stacked with future stars. Now she's combining comedy with drama and a little spycraft in the new movie Argyle. Catherine and I got together at the Spyscape Museum in New York for a Sunday sit-down. Catherine O'Hara always has been up for the unexpected.
Something a little different, right?
Yeah, fun. Spy movies involve big set pieces with people stubborn.
What happens next? It's called a cliffhanger, Mother.
For the first time in her legendary career, O'Hara is wading into the world of espionage in the new Matthew Vaughn-directed movie Argyle, whose details, appropriately, are shrouded in secrecy.
Oh my God.
The character, we can say at least,
is in the movie.
That's all we're saying. This is a brief interview.
Well, okay, it's stunt casting, because I've had about 70 children on film. I think Matthew Vaughn hired me because I'm known as a mother. Kevin!
What do you want?
Just to be near you.
This time, O'Hara is mom to Ellie Conway, an introverted spy novelist whose fictional plots begin to play out in a real-life covert organization.
I'm in some really big trouble, Mom.
Oh, so now you're experimenting with drugs.
You've mentioned it, and we're not giving away too much, but there's an action from you and your character in particular, right?
Yes, not a stirred muffin mix and a little more than that.
Yeah, I know.
I like the cryptic conversation.
No, she had the word push it.
Now people have to go see what we're talking about. O'Hara is back on the big screen after starring in a TV series that became a sensation during the early stay-at-home days of the pandemic. A show called Schitt's Creek, which, my gosh, is just one of the best shows ever made, for my money. It was hilarious, but also that love. And
it was Rickard's love, wasn't it? We happened to play a family in which the parents lived with their adult children, holed up under one roof, all together, forced to live together. Suddenly we're in this world where millions and millions of people are living that way, and then Netflix puts it out to the world that's living that way.
O'Hara plays the over-the-top Rose family matriarch, Moira, alongside the show's creators, Dan and Eugene Levy.
David, what does Bernie smell like?
Moira has become sort of an icon in her own right, going to her outfits and her wigs.
Totally.
That accent.
Well, the accent was kind of up to me. The accent, I should say. Because when people try to imitate that character, the mistake most people make is being consistent. I was like, no, don't. Your gym would have to remind me. I would lose it. He'd say, what's your favorite movie? And I'd go, the Aviator. And that would pick you, Gene.
Do you remember the reaction you got the first time you stepped out as Moira onto the set?
Laughing. Oh, my. Although the best was my wedding official look. That actually got a hush when I came out.
Well, I think we screamed. Either we're silent or we screamed with the curtains fun was a necessity growing up as the sixth of seven children in Toronto.
Your parents were funny.
Yeah, really funny.
From as early as you can remember.
It was demanded more than encouraged in our home. You know, when you have that many people at the table,
right,
you better have something at least funny to say, if not interesting.
So then at what point, though, Catherine, do you decide to pursue comedy?
I think I wanted to be an actor, but I didn't really have any connection to that world. And then my brother met a girl named Gilda Radner, and they were in this theater together. And then he would bring Gilda home.
Gilda Radner was at your family dinner table?
She had my parents improvising, doing bitch games, playing improv games. And she, that, you know, all of us, she that, oh, like, regular people that you know could actually be in show business or have a job doing this and get paid for doing this.
At 18, O'Hara followed Radner to the Second City Improv where she performed alongside Walter Levy, Dan Aykroyd, Andrea Martin, John Candy, and Martin Short.
You were with this ensemble who weren't yet who they were going to be. That's
I know,
all
so training on the job, that's good on the job training to, you know, people to be with.
And then a lot of you moved to SCTV, which
yeah.
People look back on as this sort of iconic cradle of comedy greatness.
Instead of kissing them goodnight, she would blank them all night.
Discuss world politics with them.
When you get together, you look back, because most of those you'd say, if one of us got into the movies or had a comedy career, boy, that'd be a great story. But all of you.
It's pretty crazy.
Had such success.
Second City is really beautiful training, though.
Those late night bits attracted the attention of Hollywood and eventually landed her a role in Tim Burton's 1988 hit, Beetlejuice.
Please, they're dead. It's a little late to be neurotic.
2 years later, O'Hara played mom to Macaulay Culkin's Kevin in the enduring classic Home Alone.
It's a Christmas back.
And then, its sequel.
Did you ever think by the second movie, at some point, it's just bad parenting?
John came up to me, like a little eight-year-old, in a mall.
Are you Kevin's mom?
I said, well, yeah. If I played Kevin's mom in a movie, yes.
What, you, why did you leave him?
Sorry, it was in a skirt.
So you left him? You left him twice.
I know, I'm sorry. Isn't that called abandonment?
Yes, I'm sorry.
Once, maybe. That's why it is unforgivable.
Some of O'Hara's most hilarious performances in a career full of them have come in Christopher Guest mockumentaries like Best in Show, where she often plays alongside her old friend, Eugene Levy.
God loves a terrier.
The pair's decades of on-screen magic has fans of Schitt's Creek hoping for more.
Dan Levy has been making some noise about a potential movie.
That would be nice.
You'd be into it, though?
Yeah, of course I would. But he says, and he's right, that, you know, the people who watched our show were so kind and so supportive and so with us that you want to honor that by doing something good. So I hope he comes up with a great idea.
That's right.
We're able to do it. I miss everybody.
We need to make that happen. In the meantime, Argyle from our sister company Universal Pictures is in theaters now. By the way, Catherine will reprise her role as Delia Deans in Beetlejuice 2, due out in September. Our thanks to the very cool Spyscape Museum in New York for hosting our conversation. Don't forget to subscribe to the Sunday Sit Down podcast to hear the full extended interview with Catherine O'Hara, including much more on finding the accent for Moira Rose with the help of one of the biggest pop stars in the world. About our conversation on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get yours. And next week, a new conversation and a little football at the pub with the hilarious John Oliver as he prepares for a new season of Last Week Tonight, fresh off the show's latest annual sweep of the Emmy Awards. John Oliver, next week on Sunday Today. Let's turn now and get another quick check of your local Sunday weather.
Good morning, everyone. Meteorologist Clay Anderson. Now, we have some light rain showers continuing across the Washington area, but we do see the end of the rain showers from our west. So, several more hours of the light rain, and then after that, we'll start to have some dry air moving in for the afternoon. So, with that, the forecast for today, rain ends this afternoon, so outdoor plans traveling will be fine. Cold air moves in for tomorrow with heavy rain from Monday night into Tuesday. Could end with a wintry mix. Enjoy your Sunday, everyone.
Ahead on Sunday today, our highs and lows of the week, including the eye-popping price of the ticket to today's Super Bowl that had even Mama Kelsey looking for the cheap seats. But up next, our Sunday spotlight on the unexpectedly delightful harmony of a typewriter orchestra.
I'm the master reptile.